Okay, next type of problem we want to talk about are geometry problems. There's a ton of them, but let's focus today on maybe the rectangle. Okay, so we have a rectangle here. For my first example, I have here the area of a rectangle is 120 square feet. Yes. Find the length of the rectangle if it is 1 foot less than twice the width. Okay, and I saw your eyes glazing. But I said, well, for the representation for geometry problems, I was telling you, well, what came to mind when you read a problem? You kind of had a picture in your mind, right? What picture was in your mind?
A rectangle.
A rectangle. So whatever you thought of, maybe you can draw, right? And there's your rectangle, all right? Mm-hmm. And I heard Sharon say, well, rectangle that involves length and width,
yeah.
Okay? So usually which portion, which is labeled as the length?
Horizontal.
The bigger one, right? The longer one is usually the length, and then this is the width. So these are things that came naturally to you, right? Did you see? Did I do anything? Did I even look at the problem again? No, I just said, well, the problem involves a rectangle, correct? And then Sharon said, well, length times width, length and width. So it's L and W, okay? So then after you do that, then maybe now you can go back to the problem. Let's go back to the problem and look at what we are given, okay? The first sentence says the area is 120 square feet, okay? What is area? Do you guys know what area is?
Length and width.
It's the formula is length times width, and that's going to be what?
120.
Is equal to 120. And actually, you're now doing your equation, right? So did you know something, right? So you've been telling me what to do up to now, all right? You have a rectangle, you have length and width, and you said, well, I know that length times width is 120. Okay. Do we know anything else? Now, what is now going to happen here? We have L and W, there are two letters, right? What have I been telling you all along? When you're doing word problems and you have two variables that you have, we have to produce how many equations?
Two.
We need to produce two. So far I have?
One.
All right. So think. Where will that other equation come from? Don't look at my face, it's not on my face. That other equation will come from the problem. So go back to the problem and read. Is there another thing here of equal sign that I haven't used yet? So let's look at the problem. Do you see any word that translates to the equal sign?
The width.
Is. Is. Where? Which is?
1 foot.
This is 1 foot, right? Okay. So you say, oh, I need another equal sign. This is my equal sign. Okay? Mm-hmm. And again, you say, well, I know the strategy when I see this is I need to figure out who's on the left and who's on the right. Correct? Mm-hmm. Okay. Read a problem. Who is going to be on the left of the equal sign?
Length.
Find the length of the rectangle if it, who's it?
The length.
It is the length, right? It, meaning the length. The length is. So who's going to sit on the left of the equal sign? Which letter? L, right? Okay. So if it, the length, right, is. You follow so far how we are doing it? Length is. And now we have the right side. The right side is a translation problem, right? Okay. How do you translate 1 foot less than twice the width? 1 foot less than, so where should you put the one?
At the end.
At the end as minus one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Minus one. Less than what? 1 foot less than what?
Twice
the width.
So 2W.
Twice the width, but W is width, so 2W. 2W. Did you understand that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then, yeah, you have two equations. This is your L. We don't have time to do it today, but all you do is plug that in, substitute that there, and you get your equation in W. Okay. All right, next example, the length of a rectangle. And you see the word rectangle right away, so probably you'll say, well, you drew a picture, right? I was bad, I didn't even read the problem. So I knew right away it's going to be a geometry problem involving the rectangle. Okay, so let's read. The length of a rectangle is 4 meters less than 3 times its width. And I saw Ellie, You didn't use the L and W stuff anymore, right? She saw the relationship here right away. She said, well, this is talking about the length, 4 meters less than 3 times the width. So what Ellie did was she put W here for the width, right? Mm-hmm. And rather than calling this L, she translated this already, right? 4 meters less than 3 times the width. So she has what?
3W minus 4 meters.
So she has 3W minus 4 meters. You can skip the unit for now, so it's less confusing, okay? So that is your representation. Very good. So we got rid of one letter right away, right? We just have W's, okay? So now we're ready to write our, how many equations?
Two.
One.
One, because we only need W, right? Okay, so we have an equation. The problem is we want to find the area. Let's ignore that for now, right? If its perimeter is 64 meters, so do you see the equal sign?
Is.
And the right side is?
64.
So you know right away, well, it has to be equal 64, right? Okay? What has to be 64 meters? What's sitting on the left?
The perimeter.
Perimeter. Okay, so you say, oops. Perimeter. Okay? So you have to write here an expression that will give you the perimeter of this rectangle. Okay? Does anybody remember how to find the perimeter?
Addition.
You add what?
The side lengths and...
I was emphasizing rim. Mm-hmm. Yeah, somebody, a student told me that. Easy way to remember is rim. It's like around, okay? So it's, you have to add up what? This, okay? So you add this. I don't have room on the board, so let's do the addition here. That means to say what? You have to do what? You have two of these, right? Okay, so that will give you how many? W plus W will be?
2W.
2W plus 2L.
And then here you need another one, 3W minus 4. Okay? So you can either do the addition here, alright? So you have W plus W is 2W, and then you add these two. How much do you get when you add these two?
6W
minus 8, right? Then you can plop that here. So 2W plus 6W minus 8, that's your perimeter. Okay? Alternatively, you could also have written like 2W plus 2 times 3W minus 4. Do you guys see that? 2W plus 2L, right? Mm-hmm. Twice the width plus twice the length is equal to 64. Okay? Now, before we leave this problem, in fact, let's go back to example one. Once you get your answer, make sure, well, let's go back to, let's look at this first. You will get here an equation involving W, so you will find the letter W, right? Mm-hmm. When you do this to the end, make sure you answer the question. What is the question?
Find the area.
We want to find the area. Once you find W equals something, you really just have found the width, correct? Mm-hmm. When you answer this completely, make sure you find the area. And how will you find the area? Just tell me verbally what will we do. After we find W, we can find the length, right? By plugging the W in here, correct? And then multiply those two numbers to find the area. Just one point I want to emphasize here is make sure you answer the question in the problem. For today, we're just focusing on setting up equations. Okay.